Why are so many migrants arriving on Italy's shores? This weekend, more than 1,000 migrants arrived in Italy after crossing the Mediterranean. Since the beginning of the year, arrivals have increased month on month and are far greater than in the two previous years. Since the beginning of 2023, the number of migrants arriving on Italian shores has been increasing steadily every month, from 4,962 in January, to 9,465 in February, 13,263 in March and 14,507 in April. In the first 8 days of May, more people arrived than during the whole of May last year. The UN Refugee Agency UNHCR confirmed on May 8 that year-to-date arrivals are up by 276% and month-to-date arrivals are up by 137%. Not since 2016 have so many migrants arrived in Italy in the month of January. Nevertheless, Flavio Di Giacomo, spokesperson for the UN Migration Agency IOM, warns against calling it a crisis or emergency or sounding any alarms. Just after returning from the Italian island of Lampedusa, Di Giacomo confirmed that more than 44,000 migrants have arrived in Italy since the beginning of the year. But the reasons behind this migration are quite complex to understand, and shouldn't be labeled an emergency, he said. That is a very Europe-centric way of seeing things. In a country of nearly 60 million people, Italy, and in a continent of around 450 million people, this is, in our opinion, not an emergency. Several new trends may help to explain why so many people are risking the voyage, Di Giacomo notes. First, he underlines that Tunisia has taken over from Libya as the main country of departure for migrants crossing the Mediterranean to Europe. According to UNHCR figures, 12% of arrivals to Italy in January came via Turkey, 51% from Tunisia and 37% from Libya. Di Giacomo also sees that as well as Tunisian nationals, increasing numbers of sub-Saharan Africans are also departing from Tunisia, in particular from countries in West Africa, such as Ivory Coast, the largest single group of migrants currently arriving in Italy. Di Giacomo talked to many migrants while on Lampedusa who told him, "In Tunisia, migrants are telling us that lately there has been a lot of discrimination against Western African migrants. Conditions are very harsh. Migrants are reporting they are being robbed, assaulted, quite often, and they are tired of this situation, so they are trying to leave the country. The numbers of arrivals we are recording right now are similar to those recorded in 2016, 2017. But back then there were lots of NGOs operating sea rescue, there was, the EU-led naval operation, Operation Sophia, and migrants were being rescued at sea and brought to Sicily's main ports, Augusta, Pozzallo, Catania, Messina," says Di Giacomo. In those ports there was less of a problem of reception. Italy has a population of just under 60 million people. Even a few hundred thousand migrants a year should be easily absorbed into a country that size, he points out. What is different now, and perhaps a reason that some are more concerned, thinks Di Giacomo, is the fact that most of the migrants arriving and rescued are making land first on Sicily's tiny satellite island of Lampedusa. Around 70-75% of migrants arrive now directly on Lampedusa. That is what is becoming difficult. This is an island that is maybe 20 kilometers, with a reception center that has a capacity of just 400 people. This is what is becoming challenging and difficult to manage. In fact, the Italian Defense Minister Guido Crosetto told the Italian newspaper Corriere della Sera in March 2023 that it seems to me that the exponential increase in the migratory phenomenon from the African coasts is partly, in no small measure, due to a clear strategy of hybrid war being fought by the Wagner mercenary group on Russia's payroll. According to quotes from Crosetto in Italy's financial broadsheet Il Sole 24 or, the Wagner Group, which is present in several African countries and has been strengthening its influence there since 2017, are exerting their not inconsiderable influence in some African countries. Crosetto is reported to have said that the EU, NATO, and the West need to be aware that just as cyber attacks have become part of our global experience since the conflict in Ukraine began, now the southern border of the EU is also becoming, each day, more dangerous. Uncontrolled and continuous immigration as a result of the economic and social crises is becoming a way to hit those countries most exposed to it, first and foremost Italy. According to Il Sole 24 or, Crosetto went on to say that the NATO alliance, so crucial in the Ukraine war, could be under threat if countries like Italy were left alone to deal with migration. The same point has been stressed by various members of the Italian government since taking office. ISPI did, however, provide some background to the Wagner Group theory. It said that mercenaries working for Wagner were present in Libya, Mozambique, Central African Republic, Mali, and Sudan. According to its analysts, members of Wagner were helping to run mines or provide security for these enterprises and had made as much as $250 billion, around 227 billion euros, in the last 4 years. According to ISPI sources, the Wagner Group was also present in eastern Libya, where it was known to be supporting General Khalifa Haftar. The Italian news agency ADN Kronos reported that there were about 2,000 mercenaries known to be present in Libya. Recently, the Italian government tried to use figures published by the UNHCR on the number of foreigners in Libya to suggest that there could be that many people waiting to depart for Italy. "This is untrue," says Di Giacomo. "Not everyone living in Libya, even if they are a migrant, is waiting to come to Italy. Most of those who were rejected have two chances to appeal," Di Giacomo says, meaning that they will remain in Italy for about 2 years. After that, they are told to leave the country, but for most applicants, they do not and cannot leave. "Italy has no returns agreement with most of these countries," says Di Giacomo. "That means that Italy and Europe will be facing increasing numbers of rejected asylum applicants, migrants who fall out of the system and join the numbers of unregistered, therefore becoming even more vulnerable to exploitation in order to survive. If you are just looking at the next few months, or next election, then you will only have a short-term strategy," says Di Giacomo. He says Europe needs to understand that migration is a geopolitical phenomenon and not just a humanitarian one. Nevertheless, he remains hopeful. "I think, hope, that things will start to change in Europe in the next few years. The whole system might understand that Europe needs migrants, this is here to stay, and it should be managed with long-term policies. We are just in a moment of transit, possibly. I think we will get there sooner or later. What we need to start realizing is that migration can be a resource, it is not a problem, and it is much needed."